Good day, everybody. So we just had an appraisal done on this property, and in the process of it, I wanted to make certain that we maintained that whatever the lender was going to need as far as requirements. So one of the things that often happens is a property might need to have smoke detectors or a carbon monoxide tester. In talking to the actual appraiser, though, he said that even though he is supposed to check for it, it's not necessarily his job to make it a requirement. So because I wanted to make certain that he didn't have to come back, because if we don't have what's necessary, then oftentimes an appraiser will have to come back and they'll charge the borrower to come back just for a simple picture of a smoke detector or a carbon monoxide tester. So one of the things that we do is, first of all, I check to determine what kind of loan it is. And the reason I say that is because depending upon if it's an FHA, a VA, or a conventional, oftentimes it will be different as far as what they need to have. Another thing that's interesting is that different lenders have different requirements. So first of all, I'm always prepared. I always have extra smoke detectors and extra carbon monoxide testers in my car. And the other thing too is that if it's a hardwired smoke detector, I have a retrofit one as well as the ones that are just that you can screw in. But one of the things I always want to do before I meet with the appraiser is ask the appraiser what the lender's requirement's going to be. And the reason is because if the lender only requires that there be one smoke detector in the home, then that's what we make certain that we have. If the lender is going to require that there is a smoke detector in each and every bedroom, then we want to make certain that we're prepared for that. And you know what? I've got some homes that have 5 bedrooms. This one here has 5. So that's a lot of smoke detectors to be prepared for. And not only that, I also want to make certain I got my ladder and I got a screwdriver and things like that, because there's nothing worse than having a buyer be charged for an extra appraisal going back out to verify that it's done. That's also important when I represent the buyers, because I want to make sure that my buyers don't have to do it because the sellers have taken care of what they need to take care of. Another thing too that's interesting is the rules for rentals. So if you have a property that's an income property, you might want to double check the rules and regulations for the area and the county. Right now, it seems as though everybody wants to have a smoke detector in every bedroom. That's not necessarily a lender requirement. That's just the rules and regulations to make certain that we're compliant with the new laws. So that is something to consider and understand. Some of the other things too is determining where to place a smoke detector and where to place a carbon monoxide tester. There's a lot of different information that's out there, and we have some guidelines that we can share with you. Just give us a call or text us or message us, and we'll be happy to provide that to you so that that way you can make certain that you're compliant. So this is Call Krista, OIC Real Estate Services, here out at a property that we are gonna have a successful appraisal, and we were prepared. We had our smoke detectors and our carbon monoxide testers. Have a great day, bye.